Sunshine Coast University Hospital, really interesting project. First major health PPP that Queensland government undertook. The largest non-replacement greenfield hospital built in Australia in about the last 25 years, really significant. An hour and a half north of Brisbane in a rapidly expanding area called the Sunshine Coast. Interesting demographic, a lot of older retired folk moving into the area, but also a lot of young families settling there, largely around kind of lifestyle decisions and cost of living a little bit more effective. Wonderful environment, wonderful climate. And one of the anchoring elements within the design of the building, around which the whole hospital and the clinical functionality revolves, is what's called the central courtyard space, which is a very significant proportion space, very heavily landscaped, obviously grows beautifully in that environment. And a number of very, very important patient spaces interface directly with that landscaped area. The most important movement paths within the hospital all front onto that landscaped area. And I think that has been a very successful thing, that you cannot, as a patient or a staff member or a visitor to that hospital, you cannot not experience that interface with the landscape when you use the facility.
So when we started SCU, we'd just recently completed the Gold Coast University Hospital, which was a similar scale project on paper. But we had some particular challenges on SCU that were somewhat more onerous, and that really was around our completion requirement and program. So we really knew that we had to do something different for SCU. We had to evolve our techniques and use some different tools enable for us to meet those challenging requirements for our client.
Interoperability of project files is fundamental for the adoption of digital processes and extracting the value in the construction industry. Not just in design only, but taking that through to construction and fabrication. And the more that we can use common formats like IFC, the more reliability and confidence we can have in process.
It's fair to say that when we first proposed our three-pronged approach to BIM to the client, there were some worries. We were proposing to use dROFUS, we were using ARCHICAD, and the consultants were using other BIM platforms. There was obviously the perception that on a project this size, the coordination would be too difficult. And there was also, I think, the perception that ARCHICAD itself was maybe not up to dealing with projects this size. I think we proved that combining dROFUS and ARCHICAD is a solution that helped us deliver a project of this magnitude. HDR was actually the first company in Australia to adopt dROFUS. We worked closely at the time with dROFUS head office in Norway and also with Graphisoft to develop the plugin for ARCHICAD and dROFUS, which wasn't around at the time. We were able as well to ensure that dROFUS incorporated needs that were specific to the Australian market.
On the projects of this size, FF&E is always a risk. It's always a problem. The beauty of the dROFUS system is your ability to customise and our ability to create very easily new fields in a multitude of different designations, just text, numbers, dates, and then utilise those fields to store data, retrieve data, is quite unique. We'd never come across anything like that before.
The room data, which was embedded in the model, derived from dROFUS, had so many other parameters that were needed to give accurate quantification for the QSs. So when it came to specific departments which had very, very unique finishes, it was not in the model, in the geometry, but in the metadata attached to it. So that was highly valuable for us because that information remained as the models were updated, so we could rely on where that information was and its veracity.
So it was very important for us to validate the project towards commercial acceptance in a way that was able to trace back to the original agreed design requirements. dROFUS and the use of ARCHICAD were able to seamlessly flow into our validation processes. That meant we can demonstrate that we have delivered what our requirements and our agreed output was throughout several years of design development.
So to manage a project of that size, we had to rethink some of our workflow and internal processes, and we made dROFUS a key part of that. So what we did there is we made dROFUS sort of the single source of truth, and we made sure that all the team working in our office was clear that changes were initiated in dROFUS and then they fed through from dROFUS into the BIM models. That way we always had, as I said, a single source of truth, and we had, I guess, something that was trackable in terms of changes and responsibilities.
In our experience, to be able to derive what we did in the time frame, the data that was provided through dROFUS in the ARCHICAD model that we could use was fundamental. Because it was consistent and verified from the client through the contractor, lend lease to us, we could all have confidence in using that information.
We managed approximately 1,100 user groups. Throughout those user groups, we generated approximately 51,000 pieces of feedback and approximately 45,000 pieces of equipment. The need for quality, coordinated documentation was paramount.
The Sunshine Coast University Hospital has achieved significant design recognition. We're very proud of that. From the Institute of Architects, it's achieved recognition at various levels, regional level, state level, and most significantly at the National Awards in Canberra at the end of last year. I think that is recognition of our design response, the very, very contextual Sunshine Coast fabric and feel about the building design. But in addition, I believe it's recognition of a very effective clinical response to the brief. It's a very complex brief and I think very effectively achieved in a responsive building envelope.
One of the greatest successes out of the Sunshine Coast project was being able to deliver bulletproof documentation on time and coordinated across all the various disciplines.